Which is your favorite zone in the house?
It's this one.
This one?
Yeah.
Okay.
For the reasons of showing, because I feel that most people don't know the endless possibility of the brick. They know the stuff they buy, and you know, but this shows the depth. So for me, this is the favorite place. Hey, welcome. Come on in a little bit. Have a look up into the air. Ladies and gentlemen, you are now in the Masterpiece Gallery. And of course, in the Lego house, there had to be a Masterpiece Gallery. There had to be a keystone, the brick that defines it all. So we are standing in the middle of a Lego brick. As you can see, you recognize the design. And as you come down to the historical collection, you will notice that you are in the basement, still looking up inside a brick. And I'm sure you'll hear about it. There's a mold number in the ceiling down there. There's a copyright Lego in it. So it's like you look inside a Lego brick and now you're on the top. And of course, you can also walk over this entire structure as public free entrance across the building. And you can stand literally on top of the Lego studs and have a beautiful view over the town, the airport and so on. So this is a very central element. But it's also very central because when we sort of discussed over many years now, what's the vision for this place? What should it really be and feel like? Then one of the things we of course talked about is that it's a bit like if you produce cars, we would like that people who really drive cars, racing drivers, say, this is a great car. And of course for us, it's the fans of Lego, and in particularly the adult fans of Lego. And we wanted to make sure that the house had something that would make them say, yes, there's only one place, of course, next to the founder's home, this unique Lego house, and that they would also be impressed and at awe with what they experienced in the Lego house. And therefore, in the Masterpiece Gallery, and also in select other places around the different zones, you see things created by Lego fans from all over the world displayed in these exhibits here. And yes, I think in this room currently we have from female and male adult fans of Lego from Croatia, Poland, UK, USA and Canada. We have from Japan, we have from Hong Kong, we have from Taiwan, probably forgot a country or two. Very, very amazing exhibits that I think will give people a sense when they walk out of this building, they'll say, I didn't know you could do this much and there were so many endless possibilities with the Lego brick. That's what we hope to achieve. And then, of course, we also thought, even though there are a lot of other beautiful Lego made things in this house, that of course in the Masterpiece Gallery we had to have three amazing things created by our very own Lego designers. And what they've come up with is a dinosaur made of Duplo. Of course, a very common thing, you know, even I've on Facebook had to apologize to people who step on a Lego brick when they walk out in the morning. It's one of the most common things people say to me, when was the last time you stepped on a Lego brick? In fact, it's the most asked question by any journalist to me. And so, of course, these poor dinosaurs walk out in the good old ages and they step on a Lego brick and go, ah! And there's the Duplo dinosaur, of course, a beautiful Lego dinosaur and a Technic dinosaur, signifying our three fundamental building platforms that can also be used together, but of course really are three distinctive ways of expressing. So I think that's why we sort of say, you know, this is a unique Lego experience. It's a place you have to experience and play your way through. It's not a museum, it's not just a brand house, it's a place where you create your own understanding of what Lego is and really leave with a, wow, I didn't know Lego could be all these things. And so this is what the Lego house is to us. Welcome and thanks for taking this tour. And Mike, by the way, I'm sure it's too humble to say it, but is one of the four original founders of the concept when this was a completely different building. We didn't even know we would be here. And we removed the building, we dug a big hole, built this thing in the last 4 years, and in the meantime thought about what should be in here. And Mike was the key design guy on this, so you are very honored and lucky to have him showing you around.
Can I just build on what you said? Because one of the concepts of the house, and it's answering your question, was do we change it? Well, this room is absolutely meant to be changed. These cases are like an art gallery. They're designed to have new stuff in periodically. We're thinking sort of every 6 to 12 months we will invite new adult fans to exhibit. So if you come back here, you'll always find something new in this space. The dinosaurs, they're a little bit of a different story. They're a bit more expensive. We don't expect to replace them immediately, but over time we hope the fans will tell us, you know what, those dinosaurs, we think you should put that on those podiums in the future. And of course, when the timing is right, perhaps we'll replace them one by one by one. Down in the play zones, the coloured zones, you also, we're very much having in mind that we will evolve things. Obviously, we learn as we add guests what works, what doesn't work, and we'll make the changes to the things that don't. But a lot of the things downstairs, and you'll see some of them, are designed as platforms, in that we can actually change the way the kids play or the way we theme it without ripping out the whole exhibition. So a lot of things will change quite dramatically without massive investments. So again, as you come back in the future and as a guest, you hopefully will find things, oh, I didn't see that one coming, or, oh, I see this differently now they've made these changes. So it's meant to be a living house, not a kind of Lego 2017. It's meant to be always following Lego, always following culture, always trying to maybe stay a little bit ahead of the curve in certain areas, other ways it might be reflecting what's going on. But for us, it's very important that this becomes, for the fans, the kind of center of the Lego universe. And of course, you have to be up to date to be the center of that universe, otherwise it'll move elsewhere. Yeah, so follow me this way.
Will that replace Legoland once, or will that be two different?
No, not at all. I think the Lego house is, we'll talk a lot more about it also this soon. I mean, the Lego house is a unique place that only exists one place in the world, literally next door to the house where the company was founded and the brick was invented almost 60 years ago. So it is a one of a kind, very special experience as the home of the brick. Legoland is a chain of themed attractions all over the world and quite rapidly expanding, both as an indoor attraction and outdoor attraction, will continue to do so. But I think there's an opportunity to learn from each other, and Merlin, that runs the Legoland Parks, has been a good partner to this project because they have the expertise in, you know, how do you build a place with lots of people and take care of flow and security and food and all these things. So very, very good collaboration with Legoland on this.